I wrote before.
Huh?
I've already did it before.
Okay. First time you've written this far?
The second time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, every card in the collection is special. This card is special. And I know heard one gentleman talk about it. You already know it's a PCC card. It stood for Presence Conference Committee. 1929 or so, Railway executives got together. Some of the streetcar builders at the time had said, we've got to do something about the automobile. Let's take away our riders, our revenues. The streetcars at the time were old and slow, turn of the century, and technology, pretty much. They were uncomfortable. So these guys spent $1 million to crush it down to research and design a car never been done before. They had prototypes built. They even had little old ladies in shopping bags, standing in the aisles of these prototype cars to see how much acceleration, deacceleration they could stand before they fell over. Nobody was hurt. Nobody got major time. In short, they left nothing to chance, and they designed a car which was quieter, faster, more comfortable than anything that had been seen before. It was a radical departure from what was being used in most cities at the time. And 5,000 of these were built for the United States, Canada. Probably 4 to 5 times as many were built in Europe and Russia, the Soviet Union. And satellites at the time with the PCC patents. And indeed, some of these cars are still running in museums and also out in San Francisco, which has a whole fleet of them, which is rehabilitated, painted in the cars in the colors of the different cities that we're in. Boston has a small number still running on one dedicated line. I went to school in Boston in the 70s, college up there, and they were still running. Pretty beat up, but they were still running. The Boeings came in, and I thought, oh, this is the latest thing. So that was before baseball happened. So, in general, I mean, these cars are still, you know, if they've been maintained, and Philly has some that they've rebuilt several times, they'd still be running today. Cities. So they won the battle with Boston in terms of overall streetcar systems around the country. Any question when we head back in? This car was the very last car to run the very last PCC, last streetcar of any kind. It November 3rd, 6:34 in the morning. A bunch of street railway enthusiasts, local people, brought the car into Irvington Car House. They couldn't go any farther because the superintendent had blocked the tracks with his own because otherwise the guys would see them. That was 64 years ago, which is hard to believe, but we're fortunate that we saved this car. And the colors that you see in that, the colors that was terrific. All of our PCCs at the end were all painted as sort of transportation yellow and gray blues. This is a much more elegant presentation. Any questions? You know we're nonprofit, you know we're all volunteer, most likely, and you also know that we like people to come and join and roll their sleeves up and help us with whatever they're interested in helping us with. No matter what you do for a living, what you enjoy doing, you'll find what you want to do. And yes, you can do that as far as you can do as well. Any questions before we go back in?
I have a statement. Yeah. At the museum, I saw in the display, they had a sightseeing trolley. It looked like one of these.
Oh, yeah.
Like a PCC one.
Yeah.
But on the thing, it said vandals burned it. They vandalized the streetcar, the sightseeing car,
oh,
and they buried it 60 feet under the under the
DCC, they call the Silver Sight Seer.
Yeah.
Which was actually air conditioned. It's the only one that I, DCC, I know that was ever air conditioned. And that was a cool car. It was destroyed in a, what we think was an arson, many years ago, which was the big chain. It was a very interesting car. So, these did not have air conditioning summertime.
In another statement, also on the museum, this is a Baltimore map. It shows more lines, like more train and light rail lines and stuff.
We have that, and we have system maps from here. One from 1935, which show all of the lines.
Yeah.
There are about 35 lines, streetcar lines in total, at the peak of the system, which was early 1920s. And about 1,300 cars at the most, 400 miles of track, just on the road, 400 miles of track. So we have big systems, one of the biggest in the country. Definitely one of the biggest. Okay? Well, we'll head back in. And if you want to write anything else today, of course, you know that you take your initial fare, so I'll give you a two-trip slip or any of